Hello everyone, Connor Don here, sound designer and creative pitcher at Freetag, and today I'm going to be giving you a basic tutorial on how to use Freetag's PimTek mod. Keep in mind that things in this version of the mod are subject to change in the future. Let's get started. Now, if you didn't already know, PimTek is based on the Marvel character Ant-Man, but mostly inspired by the movies.
One question. Is it too late to change the name?
So, to craft the suit, you have to use the construction table from Freecore. And as you can see, the recipes are listed in just enough items. So, this here is the Fluid Composer. This is another block added by Freecore and is used to craft slash create PIM particles responsible for making shrinking and growing work. To actually make shrink particles, first of all you're going to want to fill up your Fluid Composer with water. One bucket equals 1000 millibuckets, so if your Fluid Composer contains 1000 millibuckets, inertium dust, palladium dust, and redstone dust, you'll get half a bucket of shrink PIM particles, or 500 millibuckets. For the opposite, enlarge PIM particles, you'll need one bucket of water as well, but this time around, lead dust, palladium dust, and bone meal is needed. Once you have made your particles, you obviously want to get these in your suit. Just put a vial into the bottom slot and it will go directly into it, just like in the movies. Once you've actually created PIM particles and put them in vials, you now have to insert them into your suit. So to do this, equip your Ant-Man suit and open your regulator slash suit menu, and in there you'll see a slot in the middle, and several slots to your left and right. You can freely fill these slots with vials of any kind, but for now we'll put two shrink vials on the left and two shrink vials on the right. This will give us a maximum of four shrinks and four grows, since each size changing takes 250 millibuckets, which equals 1/4 of a bucket. The main feature of this mod is changing your size, so we're going to show you how to shrink, what its advantages are, and its disadvantages. So first of all, you're going to need a regulator. The regulator prevents you from shrinking too small or too large. You can craft a regulator using a normal crafting table and can find the recipe in just enough items. Once the regulator has been made, open your regulator suit menu where your vials are kept and put it in the middle. You are now ready to shrink. So, on the top left, the suit has two abilities, one to shrink and one to grow. What we want to do is press the shrink button, and when we do, this will happen. Now you're tiny. This provides many advantages such as being hard to hit, moving faster than normal, being more durable, and having a very, very strong punch. The only disadvantage is using PIM particles can alter your brain chemistry, so being small or large for too long can cause you to have nausea, suffocation, or passing out. The time varies depending on your suit, but we'll get into that later. Also, note that if you remove your suit or your helmet, you will start to suffocate as the air particles are too big for you to breathe. As you probably know, in the movies and in the comics, Ant-Man dons the name Giant Man. He uses the suit to make himself around 60 feet tall. To do this, you're going to need a tier 2 suit, and once you have acquired a tier 2 suit, you're going to want to be in a normal height and press the grow button. When you're in giant mode, you have a great many advantages, but also just as many disadvantages. The advantages include negated fall damage, increased durability, just slightly stronger than being tiny, increased strength, again just slightly better than being tiny, and increased reach. But as with all good things in life, there are strings attached. When giant, you will have cinematic cam forced on by default. Your mouse movements will slowly lag behind, emulating the feeling of being large and slow. Also, due to the increased size, it can be harder to hit players and mobs as they are smaller than you. After a short while as well, you will slowly begin to pass out as your body cannot support being that large for that long. You will also notice that your hunger bar will go down quicker, and once it does, your screen will begin to fade in and out along with your FOV, and you'll be stopped from moving. If you continue to be large after all this, you will pass out completely, and your suit will revert you back to the default size automatically. The Pymtek suits have tiers. Both Ant-Man and Wasp suits have various advantages and disadvantages. You can always stick with the basic tier 1 suits, but if you want to upgrade them and get better features, you can sink more expensive materials into the crafting recipe to upgrade them. Ant-Man with the tier 1 Ant-Man suit and the Wasp suit, you only have 4 slots with the tier 1 suit and you will pass out almost immediately when large, if you even somehow manage to become large, and these suits have the same defense level as leather. With the tier 2, you have 8 slots for vials, so you can endure being large and small for 1 minute and 30 seconds. This armor also has the same level of durability as iron armor. You can also set a custom size using your regulator menu with this slider. With tier 3, you have 12 slots for vials, so you can endure being large and small for a grand total of 3 minutes. The armor now has the same durability level as chainmail. It is also important to note that this tier is on par with Wasp tier 2. The only difference between the Ant-Man suit and the Wasp suits is that the Wasp suits can fly and shoot lasers. Pymtek not only allows you to shrink yourself, but also to shrink surrounding entities and structures. First of all, we are going to discuss Pym Shrink and Grow Discs. These are small sharp discs that you can throw at entities and structures to either shrink and or grow them.
Has no weapons, so I made you these discs. Red shrinks, blue enlarges.
Just right click and you will throw them at an entity or structure. To shrink your structures, you need this block called the Structure Shrinker and the item Structure Shrinker Remote. First of all, the block needs energy and shrink Pym particles. After that, right-click the block with the remote and both will be linked. Then, you will need to set the two corners for your selection of what you want to shrink. To do that, simply left-click a block to set corner 1, and shift-left-click to set corner 2. Now that we've done that, we can simply go back to the Structure Shrinker, click on Shrink, and there you go! Now you can pick up your building, carry it around, and when you want to enlarge it back again, throw it on the ground, throw an enlargement disc at it, and there you go. You can also rotate it in its shrunken form by right shift clicking it like this. Well everyone, thanks for watching. We hope this tutorial was informative and remind you that not everything in the mod was listed here, and we encourage you to look for more Easter eggs and additional features on your own. Also, in the future, try not to screw with the regulator, and...
ants!
Well, we'll see everyone later, and remember, Baskin Robbins always finds out.